गुड मॉर्निंग मैम। ओके मैम, ओके मैम। एक्चुअली आई अटेंडेड, आई जस्ट रोट माय रोल नंबर देन आई जस्ट वेंट मैम।
Okay, Prajwal has WhatsApped me that we are still attending the other class. We will join soon.
ओके मैम, ओके।
Shrek and Prince, if you were absent in the last class, I want you to take down this problem. Okay? A balance sheet
Yes,
of
sir.
a company is given as on 31st March. So take down these balance sheet. We will try to calculate all the ratios. Okay? In today's class. I'm just waiting for the others to join and then we can start away with the problem.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Prince Tonger or Sheikh, can you please log into the other class and check if the class is still going on?
ओके मैम। मैम इट हैज एंडेड मैम, जस्ट नाउ।
Has ended just now.
या
Okay. See, I think students can eventually join in. So basically in this problem, can you see the paint file that I've shared with you?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so basically in this problem, they've given a balance sheet of a company as on 31st March. They've given us the balance sheet, which consists of liabilities and assets. Like in the liabilities, you have share capital, you have profit loss account, you have general reserve, you have 12% debentures. They have calculated and given us the value. They have given sundry creditors. They have given bills payable. All these values have been given. And they have given us the total liability value here. And the asset side, we have land, building, plant, machinery, stock, sundry debtors, bills receivable, and cash at bank. And the total value also they have given us. With this balance sheet, they want us to calculate the current ratio, quick ratio, inventory to working capital. What is the formula for working capital? The working capital management, we have done the formula. What's the formula for working capital? Hello, forgotten.
Ma'am, current assets minus current liabilities, ma'am.
Superb. Current assets minus current liabilities. Then they've asked us to compute debt to equity ratio. They've asked us to find out the proprietary ratio and capital gearing ratio. Current assets to fixed assets, they have asked us to find out, right? In the last classes, when I did the when we discussed the entire theory part, in that for each one of the formulas and what to be included under current assets and current liabilities that we have already discussed in the previous classes, today we'll go with the computation of the problem, right? So in the first problem, they're asked us to find out the current ratio. What is the formula for the current ratio?
Current assets by current liabilities.
Current ratio is given by current oh God, what happened to the screen? Current assets by current liabilities. Now, what and all will come under the current assets? Can you tell me the assets, what and all will come under the current assets? We're calculating current assets. So what and all will come under the current assets? These are all our fixed assets, like plant and building, plant and machinery and all our fixed assets, like our stock, sundry credit, sundry debtors, bills receivable, cash at bank. All these things will be coming under the current assets. Can you sum up this value and tell me how much is it?
3,50,000.
It is 3,50,000, correct? 2 plus 1, 3, 3 and 50,000, 3,50,000. Now, can you tell me what will be the current liabilities? Current liabilities is sundry creditors and bills payable. I think in the last class when I gave you the formula, there only I have given what and all will come and I have asked you to take down. So, current liabilities, you have your sundry creditors and bills payable. That is 1 lakh plus 50,000. So you will get 1,50,000. Now, what's the answer? What will be the ratio? Can you compute this?
2:1.
2:1. The ratio is 2:1. So this will be the answer. Have you all got this?
Yes,
how many students have joined in the class now? Has everybody joined in? Only you both are there? Okay, not
few more of them.
Okay. So any doubts here for those who have joined late? So we have computed what is current ratio. The current ratio formula is current assets minus current assets by current liabilities. To find out current assets, we leave up the land and building, plant and machinery. We sum up all this.
Well, excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
2.3 is 2:1.
Yeah, 2.33, but since any value, okay, if you want to show it as 2.33 is to 1 is also fine. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, if you have no doubt, shall
Yes,
we
ma'am.
go back to quick ratio?
Yes, ma'am.
I'll clear this. What's the formula for quick ratio?
Ma'am, quick assets by quick liabilities.
Quick assets by quick liabilities, or I will consider it as, you can also tell them as liquid assets by liquid liabilities. Liquid liabilities. Now, what is this liquid assets which we have here? Sundry debtors, bills receivable, cash at bank. These three contribute as the liquid assets, right? So it is, how much is the sum now?
1,50,000.
1,50,000. What about our liquid liabilities? These doesn't come liquid. This is not liquid. This is not liquid. This is not liquid. Only sundry creditors and bills payable will be coming under the liquid liability. So it's also 1,50,000. So what will be the ratio? 1:1. The ratio is 1:1. Any doubts still here?
No, ma'am.
No. Next we have the inventory to working capital. Okay, so inventory to working capital, we'll try to find out. If you have copied, I'll clear this. So inventory to working capital. Inventory to working capital. The formula is given by inventory by working capital. What is the inventory value? What is in the inventory now? This stock value, right? So that is amounting will be 2 lakhs. So under the inventory, you have your shares, your stocks, which is about 2 lakhs. Your working capital, how do you compute? You said the formula, the working capital formula is current assets minus current liabilities. Your current assets value was, by the previous formula, you computed it was 3,50,000. 3,50,000. What is your current liabilities? It was 1,50,000. So what will be the value? Okay, what will be your working capital now? What will be your working capital now? What is your working capital now? 2
2 lakh
lakh. So what will be your ratio now?
one, ma'am.
1:1.
One.
It's not, we can't write it as 1 since they're asking us the ratio. It is 1:1 only. Any doubts still here?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay, so the
No, ma'am.
next will be so next will be debt to equity ratio. Can somebody tell me what is the formula for debt to equity ratio? What is the formula for debt to equity ratio?
लॉन्ग टर्म फंड्स, लॉन्ग टर्म डेब्ट्स बाय शेयर होल्डर फंड्स।
सुपर लॉन्ग टर्म डेब्ट्स बाय शेयर होल्डर्स फंड। फंड सो टू फाइंड आउट लॉन्ग टर्म डेब्ट्स, व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर लॉन्ग टर्म डेब्ट्स? From where do we find out this long term debts? You look at your balance sheet only, you can get to know. Twelve percent debentures is 4,20,000. So debentures means which comes under the long term debts. So this will come under as your long term debts, 4,20,000. Now what's the formula for shareholders' funds? Can somebody tell me what will be the formula from the in the last class when I had discussed, I had given you the formulas. What will be the formula for shareholders' fund? It will be the sum of share capital plus reserve plus the surplus amount we have in the process, right? So in this case, the shareholders fund, if you take the share capital values 2 lakhs, the surplus, that is your profit and loss account, from that you have 30,000. Your general reserve, you have 40,000. So how much will be the amount for shareholders fund that you can invest? What will be the sum up to? You can open your previous formulas which we have discussed. From there, you can refer your shareholders' funds. If you want, I can share that file with you. Debt to equity ratio. Debt to equity ratio is long term debts by shareholders funds. Your shareholders fund is equity share capital plus a share capital, which is also called a share capital, plus reserves and surplus minus fixtures asset. Here they've not given us any fixtures asset, but they've given us reserves and surplus. So we are taking all the sum over here and trying to find out what will be our shareholders fund. Is it clear? I hope you have taken
Yes,
down
ma'am, sir.
all this before when we discussed in the last previous classes. Shall I move on?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, can you please share this file, ma'am? PPT, ma'am.
Shall I put it normally in your classroom?
Ma'am, after class.
After class, I will share. Okay, fair enough. If you want to cross-check, I will put it now only. I think I'll put it now only so that for reference you can use. People who have not written down can use that. I'm just posting it. Just give me a minute. I have posted the material. If you want, you can open your classroom and check these values there. Okay? Check the formulas from there.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. So now, can you tell me what will be the shareholders' fund now? It is share capital plus reserve and surplus from the profit and loss account. You have 30,000. So what will it be? 2,70,000. Is it clear? Is it 2,70,000?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So what will be the ratio now? Can you tell me what will be the ratio?
One point five, ma'am. 1.5 is 2.
1.5:1. So this will be the ratio for this one. Can you compute what is proprietary ratio? I've given you the slideshow. I think by now you should be in a position to compute what is proprietary ratio. What's the formula for proprietary ratio? If you don't have, I will give you the proprietary ratio, that is proprietary ratio. Is equal to shareholders fund by total assets. So what's the value? Can somebody compute
Ma'am,
it?
shareholder funds and proprietary funds are same.
Same.
Okay.
Proprietors fund by total asset is also same. Shareholders fund by total asset is also the same formula. Can you give me the answer here? So what is shareholders fund from the previous thing we computed? What was the shareholders fund you computed? What is the value? So what is shareholders fund, boys? I think in the last when we computed debt to equity ratio only, there only we computed what is shareholders fund, long-term debts by shareholders fund, right? What is the value you got for shareholders fund? Boys, am I asking you something different? Asking you what is the value of shareholders fund? Are you taking it down? Prajwal, what is the shareholders fund value? All are leaving the class. Sheikh Manan, what is the shareholders fund value? Boys, until unless you get an input, I'm not going to continue. What is the shareholders fund? The last formula we computed debt to equity ratio, right? There the formula was long-term debts by shareholders fund. You already computed what is shareholders fund. I'm asking you what is the shareholders fund value now?
2,70,000.
It is
2,70,000.
2,70,000. So 2,70,000. What will be your total assets value? Total assets value. What is the total assets value you have? Can't you see the sum here? Assets total asset value is here. So how much is it?
8,40,000.
Is 8,40,000. Now, can you tell me what will be the ratio now? What is the ratio now?
1:3, ma'am.
1:3. I'm getting it as 0.32:1.
Ma'am, 0.32. Yes, ma'am, that's right.
0.32:1.
Yes, ma'am.
Shall I do with the next formula? Is everybody getting the same value?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so please note down. Are you noting it down? Shall I clear it?
1 minute, ma'am.
Okay. Shall I clear it? Why should I clear it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next will be capital gearing ratio. Maybe this formula I might have missed somewhere. So capital gearing ratio, please take down capital gearing ratio. Is given as fixed interest bearing securities, fixed interest bearing securities the entire thing divided upon equity share capital, equity share capital. Equity share capital. So fixed interest bearing securities is our 12% debentures, that is 4,20,000, and equity share capital is 2 lakhs. So the answer will be 4,20,000 divided upon 2 lakhs. Can you tell me what will be the ratio now? Maybe it should be 2:1.
Yes,
Two
ma'am, two is
point
to
one,
one.
2.1:1, I think, huh?
Yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am.
One. Okay. Next is current assets to fixed assets. The thing only says the formula is current assets divided by fixed assets. The current asset value is how much you calculated earlier. How much was current asset? 3,50,000. Fixed asset is these two. That will be 4,90,000 will be your fixed assets. Current assets will be, you calculate in the first formula when you calculated your current ratio, right? So it was 3,50,000, right? So current ratio, you said that it is current assets by current liabilities. In that, your current assets value was 3,50,000. Are you getting it? 3,50,000 divided by your fixed assets are these two, right? That will be 4,90,000 is 4,90,000, correct? Anybody is having doubts here? Anybody is having a doubt here? The formula for current assets to fixed ratio is, you need to find out what is current asset, you need to find out what is your fixed asset. Your fixed asset is definitely your land, building, plant and machinery. So you're summing up those two values. And current assets you've already computed when you computed your current ratio, such as stock plus sundry debtors plus bills receivables plus cash at bank. When you sum up all that, you got it as 3,50,000. So it is 3,50,000 by 4,90,000. So what will be the ratio here? Can somebody compute and tell me?
0.71:1.
0.71:1. Is it clear now? It's one of the easiest unit, but you need to memorize all the formulas.
Yes, ma'am.
You need to keep a track of all the formulas and just compute all these values here. Shall we go ahead with the next problem? Has everybody copied the solution? Today's assignment in classes, you need to solve all these problems and post it in the Google Classroom. Okay? Shall I post the next question now?
Yes, ma'am.
Just a second, I will dictate the question to you all, but I'm just don't take down this. Is the paint file being shared with you? Can you see the paint file?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, the question is, I want you to take down the question. From the following particulars, found in the trading profit loss account, found in the trading profit loss account of a company limited, work out the operation ratio, work out the operation ratio of a business concern of a business concern. The trading account is given here, your profit and loss account is given here. So we need to compute our operating ratio. So first you take down this question, then we will get into the details. The moment you have taken down, just let me know. If you have done, we'll go with the solution. Shall we solve? Have you all taken down?
Yes, one is more.
Okay. So now, in this, we need to find out our operating ratio. To find out operating ratio, what the formula is, I think we have discussed in the last class itself. Operating ratio, which is given as, can somebody tell me, is equal to cost of goods sold plus other operating expenses. In the working capital management also we have done this. This cost of goods sold, cost of goods sold plus other operating expenses by net sales into 100. So this will be the formula for operating ratio. This formula we have discussed even in our working capital management as well. So operating ratio is nothing but cost of goods sold plus other operating expenses by net sales into 100. The entire thing into 100. Am I clear with the formula?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, I have to compute what will be the cost of goods sold. So what is the cost of goods sold? So for that cost of goods sold, first I have to know what is the opening stock. What is the opening stock value now? Opening stock value is 1400. Super, 1400. It is 1400. And what was the purchases? Along with the opening stock, we need to add the purchases also to find out what will be the cost of goods. So what will be the purchases value which is given for us is 6,400. Now what is the direct expenses which is involved in the making is 300, right? So direct expenses is 300. So what will be the entire value now? If you sum up, how much you will get? Okay. Now for this, I need to subtract my closing stock. So I have to subtract my closing stock. So closing stock is the value is how much? How much is it given? Closing stock value is given here. It's 600. So it is minus 600. If I remove from 1800, 600, how much I'll get?
7500.
You will get 7500. 7500. Okay. Now we have to compute. We got the value of cost of goods sold. I have to find out what are the other operating expenses. Other operating expenses are administration expenses, selling and distribution expenses, financial expenses. We have got here. If I sum up this 1600 plus 300 plus 400, I will get somewhere around 2000. Correct, right? Operating expenses is equal to sum of administrative expenses. You can write down fully. I'm writing administrative plus selling and distribution expenses plus financial expenses. So if you sum up everything, that is 1600 plus 300 plus how much? 100. So you will get, make, you will get it as 2000. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now so I don't have space here, so I'm going to utilize my space here. So now operating ratio is nothing but operating ratio OR is nothing but cost of goods sold was 7500. Other operating expenses is 2000 plus 2000. What is your net sales value is given here, which is
10,000.
It is 10,000. I have to multiply into 100. So how much will I get? Now what will be the ratio value? Since it is in 100, you will get it in the form of percentage. So how much is it? Somewhere around
95%.
95. Okay, 95% you will get the answer. Is it clear?
Yes.
Any doubts here? Any doubts here?
No.
No. Okay, now I'm going to give one more problem, which I'll give it as an assignment. You can try this problem at home. In the meantime, when I'm taking attendance, you please take down. See, this is some company's profit and loss account, okay? For the year 31st December, they have given us the profit and loss account. You need to compute all these ratios. This will be your assignment for today's class. Okay, so I'm going to post the same question in your Google Classroom as well. So make sure you attempt it. So due date shall I give by today 4:30? When, how much time
Yes,
you
ma'am.
need to do this?
Now we have lab.
Yes, ma'am. By tomorrow will be okay.
Tomorrow. Tomorrow what time? By before I come to your class, that is tomorrow Thursday. Tomorrow first hour I want the problem. Today shall I give till 8 o'clock? By 8 can you solve? The due date will be by today 8 p.m. Okay.
Okay.
So make sure you complete this problem. So in this, I've asked, if you see the problem, it is very simple. We are asking gross profit ratio, net profit ratio, operating ratio, and we are asking material consumed, labor, and production overhead ratio. This is all very simple. Even in your working capital management, you would have done all this. You just have to just overlook upon this and try to find out the ratios. Maybe the last few slides in which is there, all the formulas are there. It's not very difficult. It'll hardly take about 5 minutes or 10 minutes time. Okay. Maybe for searching formulas, you might take some time, but otherwise calculation part is very simple. Please try to complete this problem in the next class, by next class. Can we give your attendance, please? Prajwal Patil. Prajwal Patil.
Present, ma'am.
Ranveer Dorai. Basvaraj. Baswaraj, Chandan,
Ma'am, present, ma'am.
Nilesh,
Present, ma'am.
Prince,
Present, ma'am.
Sharanaya, Sheikh,
Present,
Sumuk,
ma'am.
Prajwal R,
Present, ma'am.
Prajwal R, not
Present, ma'am.
okay. Rajat Kumar, okay. Pupila Chanakya, Simika,
Present, ma'am.
okay. Please complete the problem and by the due time, you please submit the problem. Is it clear? Okay, then thank you. We'll meet in the next class.
Thank you.